You're firing me? Henry, I need this job.
Well, I am sorry. Okay, well, this is kind of what I'm talking about.
What? Am I on fire?
No.
Just lost my job. I need a drink. Please, Henry, don't.
All you had to do was be on time and not get drunk. It's not a difficult job description.
Because I was born short.
What? No.
You think it's easy holding that fucking tray up so high?
Oh, Tim, this is only because you're a shitty worker. That's
Henry,
it.
Henry, the promoter's looking for you.
Yes, okay, just in 1 second, Lydia.
Boss is busy firing me because I make him uncomfortable.
It's not true.
My car payments. I'm going to lose my car and my life will collapse because of you. Are you happy?
No, I'm not happy.
You love the power. Big boss, man. You're going to think about this tonight, jerk off.
Everybody, huh? Okay, come on. Yeah, Henry and I used to sling derbs back in the day. Remember that, huh? Before he left to become a big star, but now he's back. Where's your shirt?
Oh, white wine, please.
Right up.
Hey, I know you. You look so familiar to me.
I was thinking the exact same thing. That kind of face.
Interesting.
MILF action.
Huh?
You an actor? Ron said you're like a star or something?
No.
Who's your agent?
State Farm.
Awesome. They give you some good auditions and stuff?
I don't really act anymore.
That's cool. So like what are you doing now?
Bartending?
Dude, nice.
Yeah.
Where?
Here.
Very nice.
Why am I involved in this all of a sudden?
You work here?
Bartending tonight.
Good to know the bartender. These things are so boring. I'm Ula.
Henry.
Rum and Coke, my drink. So when you see me coming...
I'll be ready.
You have nice eyes, Henry.
Back. Hold my horse on the beach in Phuket.
Scotch.
It's a lot more fun than how I screwed up my back.
I'd share, but it was my last one. Unless you go for the all natural stuff.
Why, yes, I do.
You look familiar to me.
You an actor?
It's one of those faces.
Wait a minute. Were you that guy?
Well, who is in charge here? Because I'm trying to figure out if an employee jerking off and handing out semen samples falls under needs work or completely unsatisfactory.
Is there any way I could convince you he was going the extra mile?
Excuse me. Where's Roman?
He's in makeup. We switched.
Jackal Onassis?
I want to be called Dennis.
Do you remember? And then we realized that it went from here
and... Stroll over.
killer bug.
We had sex in San Francisco. It was so much fun.
It was so much fun.
Hey, are we having fun yet? Dude, that's why I know you. You're that guy.
Wait a minute.
Whoa. Wait yeah? A sec.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I mean, we have our ups and downs and everything, but...
Okay, I got it. It's been driving me crazy. The beer head. Are we having fun yet? He looks like that guy.
Come on, please. Just once. Please.
Are we having fun yet?
Are we having fun yet?
Hey, are we having fun yet? Right? From those beer commercials. That is awesome.
Are we having fun yet? Remember?
That's actually the guy.
Are we having fun yet? Huh?
Are we having fun yet?
Hey.
Yes. I'd rather not.
Are we having fun yet? Are we having fun yet? Are we having fun yet?
Yeah, that was me.
Wow.
Emphasis on the was.
Oh, well, what do you do now?
Still trying to figure that out.
Oh, but every week, the same boring people.
Yeah?
Every week.
Well, seems interesting, though.
So I smell nice?
Yeah, very nice.
Your breath okay?
Very minty.
Just Mookie, shh. Go away, go away.
Who you are? Does this name sound familiar? Johannes Heesters,
no.
Hitler's favorite actor.
Why do you know that shit?
I retain information.
You're going to have a problem, man. That's weird.
Zoltan said that the water drops glistening in the sunlight off my breasts made him cry. Murderers don't have poetry like that in their soul.
So Henry, you were like a big deal at one point.
Yeah.
You gotta tell me what to do. Like, how do I know which of the little people to, like, totally crush?
Oh, it's just totally random. You just start arbitrarily fucking people over.
Cool. I can do that.
Does this mean you don't want to read the sonnets I composed?
Sonnet?
Yeah.
Is that good for you, huh?
Well, the sex was adequate, but the connection to another living soul in my abyss of loneliness and despair, that was profoundly good.
Sex was Adam.
No, sorry, it was fine. You're probably just distracted or something.
Right. What's his shirt size? I'm guessing 1634. Dune sprained his ankle. Come with me.
We kind of need him here.
I need a man. You need Ron, and the guy working the toilet sign is too ratty looking, and you're too old.
You really should take your underwear off. Jets feel great on your balls. You know, I should probably...
Hey, did you mean what you said earlier?
What about, like, connecting and souls?
No, about the sex being adequate.
Look.
No, I just need you to know that I'm not the pancake lady.
The pancake lady?
The pancake lady. She makes the best pancakes in all of the kingdom, that she only makes one pancake for every person.
I've never heard this fable.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It is. It's the nicest thing. It's really great. There's just one thing that I don't get, personally, and that is, it says right here, this schoolgirl is in for a surprise. She's going to get a face full of jizz, and she's going to like it.
She's gonna like it.
Yeah. So...
Not the gift.
Well, which one is a surprise?
Stranger rides into town and says, "Hey, can I get one of those pancakes everybody's raving about?" So she makes one and he eats it. And he says, "You know, it's good, decent pancake, not like the best I've ever had or anything. I don't know, maybe you were distracted." So she makes him another one, and then another one, and another. She makes him like a whole bunch of pancakes, and he's full. And he says to her, "Listen, I have to admit, that actually was one epic pancake." So she cuts him off. See, the thing is, the first pancake she made for him was epic. He was just messing with her mind, man. He was just tricking her into putting out pancakes. Which is hilarious, I think, because really, the pancake lady, she was just like tossing in that first one as a sympathy pancake anyway, so.
Well, pancake lady sounds like a whore.
Come on, Henry. You can be two things in life. You can be an achiever, or you can be a fuck-up.
Okay. And which one are you being right now?
I'm an achiever.
Okay, well, then I'm definitely a fuck-up. And gotta say, standing here watching you light a flag on fire in a parking lot, I feel kind of okay about it.
Henry, don't be a quitter. Don't be a quitter. Do something. Do something.
You put that next to the one of you and Arnold shaking hands.
Copy that. Oh, and tell the blonde, thanks for the concern, but I got laid 3 weeks ago, so I'm good.
Huh. Ron, why didn't you just take the day off and go to your reunion? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? When Party Down said that they got this gig, I said, I want to work it, man. I mean, these people only know me as Bluto, a wild and crazy guy. I want to show them that I got my shit together.
Bluto, like Popeye?
No.
Like the fat guy from Popeye? Were you fat?
No.
Were you a fat guy in
no,
high school,
like,
Ron?
No, like Belushi's character in Animal House, okay? It was fun and crazy.
Two gin and tonics, please.
Listen, guys, I know you like to fool around, but I was wondering if you could maybe act like I'm a good boss and respect me, you know? Because if they see the kind of guy that I am now, the new Ron, then that would really help me out a lot. And the other guy said okay, so...
Yeah, sure, Ron.
Excellent, thank you.
Yeah. Hey, guys, I need some pee. Completely dried up.
Wait, what?
This douchebag's been fucking with Roman, and now it's payback. The code.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what's the code?
The code. It's like a guy code.
You wouldn't go.
Yep.
Shut up.
I'm right before.
Oh, really?
Ah, I kind of like this.
Yeah?
Casey, circulate. Henry, someone peed all over the ladies' room.
Oh, well, I'm actually kind of busy, Ron.
Clean up the fucking piss!
You carried Ron today. I know that. You should call me sometime.
Oh, I actually just got promoted here.
Wasn't I too old?
I don't mean for a job. I mean socially.
Nobody puts baby in a corner.
Yes.
It says the kid did it for me.
Mr. V.
It's me. I mean, I didn't even think he liked me.
You with a giant boner.
I didn't. That's an arm.
It's attached to your crotch.
Well, it's not Rembrandt. He's fine.
Oh, yeah, that is a boner.
Don't worry about me. You're not the only man in the world, even if Bryce did like you.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, I don't think he did. I don't think that's an arm.
Nope. That's your dick.
Hey, sorry, man. Can't stay here.
Okay.
Are we having fun yet?
Yay! We have it.
Well, fuck that! Nobody puts baby in a corner!